Gus is the cat at the theater door. His name, as I ought to have told you before, is really Asparagus, but that's such a fuss to pronounce that we usually call him just Gus. His coat's very shabby, he's thin as a rake, and he suffers from palsy that makes his paw shake. Yet he was in his youth quite the smartest of cats, but no longer a terror to mice or to rats. For he isn't the cat that he was in his prime, though his name was quite famous, he says, in his time. And whenever he joins his friends at their club, which takes place at the back of the neighboring pub, he loves to regale them if someone else pays with anecdotes drawn from his palmiest days. For he once was a star of the highest degree. He has acted with Irving, he has acted with Tree, and he likes to relate his success on the halls, where the gallery once gave him 7 cat calls. But his grandest creation, as he loves to tell, was Fire for Fiddle, the Fiend of the Fell. Then if someone will give him a toothful of gin, he will tell how he once played a part in East Lynne. At a Shakespeare performance, he once walked on pat, when some actor suggested the need for a cat. And he says, as he scratches himself with his claws,